Hey guys, just a quick video here to show you. If you've got a 4.6 liter Ford engine in a pickup or a Crown Vic, or I don't know if they put them in Mustangs or not, but this particular car here did not have any check engine lights on, but my fuel trims were anywhere between positive 3 to positive 11. I chased and chased and chased. I couldn't find vacuum leak while my fuel trims were. I'd already discovered a stuck open injector and fixed that, but that wasn't that. Now I'm on to something else. At this point, I'm looking for, you know, why are my fuel trims around, you know, 7, 8, 9, 10 positive long term? And anyway, I got to looking, and this particular tube right here, it goes from the purge valve to the throttle body. I had a pair of squeeze off pliers, and I come out here one day and I just squeezed it on here right next to the fitting, and all of a sudden the car started running perfect. And not that it wasn't running good before, but as soon as I clamped it off, I realized it was running way better. So then I got to feeling this tube, and the tube that was on there was, I think it had been made out of rubber, and the thing left my fingers just jet black, and like the hose became porous. And yes, you are gonna, when the purge valve opens, it is essentially a vacuum leak to the computer, but not much, because it can slowly suck down the gas tank pressure into a negative, and it won't affect the engine like a wild, you know, wide open vacuum leak would create. But even still, when I clamped this down, it was like I just shut off a constant vacuum leak. So anyway, my point is, if you've got one of these 4.6 liter Ford engines, the two valve Ford engines in a Crown Vic or a pickup or something, and you're chasing fuel trims that you can't get down to normal, this one tube right here, my local Ford dealer had it in stock. The part number's right on it. I'll post it below if you don't have it on yours. It was like $21, come in a Ford parts bag, come with new ends on both ends, just snapped it on, bam. Now my long-term fuel trims are average right around 0 to +3. I've never really seen them much over 3. In fact, the day that they were got up to 3, it was negative 10 degrees below 0 Fahrenheit here that day. So thick air needs more fuel. That's about as good as it can get. So if you're having a trouble with your car, check out this. It's called the vapor tube assembly. Check out that vapor tube assembly. That might be your culprit. Anyway, just a quick one for today. Please be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.